I have a question for Chisei. Is Yerma strong?
just a bit. No, I get to be on the receiving end of Yerma, and it was not fun.
Dude, don't worry, man. I was on the receiving end of that too.
She is very, very fun to play.
Oh my goodness.
So, the main event.
We're starting with me. So I was talking about Missile. I think you see the trend I'm going in here. A lot of bows. But yeah, it's a really difficult thing to build these types of roster. My thinking was to try to lean initially, at least in my team building, into the fire and wind units, because I know that meta very well. I've used it a lot, and I'm able to build Odo teams around that. So I wanted that kind of cherries plus Cytia combination as one of my possibilities. I like the notion of Raldor to completely shut down ice teams because Kingmont was too expensive. So I had a portion of my thinking around that. But then I also, you know, we have to pick multiple elements because we're limited to two per element. So then I had to go for a lot of other stuff. I guess instead of speaking about my reasoning, I'd be curious to just hear your thoughts reacting to this.
Okay, son?
Sure. I can go. I'm looking at this for the first time, so it's going to be very, you know, quick initial impression. So I'm sure I'll miss, you know, certain things and stuff like that. But the first couple things I try and look at is, like you said, like elemental synergies. Obviously, you can only have two of each. So I immediately look at like wind and fire. Like, you have some strong wind and fire units that you can do like some dark tetra synergy or something like that off of. Obviously, you have ice and water. You can do similar things there. You have the Liarte 30 cost, which I don't think I did in my team here, but it is just always nice having a 30 in there just to give you like ultimate flexibility, because you never know when there's a time where you want to throw two units together that maybe you weren't even thinking about necessarily, but you can do then.
Mm-hmm.
I do find it interesting. You have five bow users. I don't remember what the total was for bow, but it was like 10 or 11. I think you have.
It was 15, so I have a third of them. Yeah,
so you have 33%
of them. I did not expect that. I was really thinking there would be a lot of missiles because you don't know the map. There are a ton of maps in there that units are super far away from, and they can't cross in the middle. But I guess we'll see. That's why I have no guns as well, because I dislike not having lob attacks.
Oh, shoot, I didn't check the map, so I didn't took that into consideration, so I may be screwed against you.
I like that you have like some fist synergy with Perrin and Raldor. Obviously, if you're going to play those two together, you're throwing in Liarte with it. Liarte is a really fun unit, I will say. Shout out to players who can utilize her effectively, because it really depends on what skills you have turned on or off. I say this a lot in my shoutcast, but what statuses do you want? Do you want charm charge going on? Do you want stop? Do you want the immobilize and poison?
Yes, super long range immobilize. Like, there's a ton of ways you can do that.
I've seen multiple people. I've seen a Liarte solo in Alphonse, because she poisoned and immobilized him. He couldn't move. He was just stuck poison, and he just died before he closed the gap. And I was like, that's 30 costs well spent.
Yeah, so that's really interesting. And then I guess another twist that I just want to highlight in my thinking is I want people to look at my roster and be like, he could throw in evasion and mess me up if I don't build for it. So I have two very high synergy earth units that can evade very, very well, which is kind of in my mind, it's a stopper. When people read your roster, they'll be like, I have to equip my units with proper accessory or proper guaranteed hit, or I face a potential auto loss scenario. So having them in there, I might not use them, but because they exist in my roster, they force my enemies to dump stats into accuracy. So when I'm thinking of building a team or a roster, that's the kind of tool that I want to have in my hand.
Absolutely. No, I like that a lot.
I mean, you kind of nailed everything that I was going to say, but I was also just going to say that not only do you have the missile game locked down with all the bow units, but you also got Raldor, who's in a great for going against the missile comps. So if you ever get in that head-to-head, you know, you got you got the tech.
Yeah, I'm still in the old meta where people would be gunned down before reaching the enemy team. It's not as common now, but I have traumas.
I'll only give one hint to you, Randall. In auto, the best weapon for Learte is Bowtie.
I'll take that into consideration.
If you watch WDL, I think it's the fight between Alcar and Ready Player Will. He has won game one only because his Learte had Bowtie.
I'll go and watch that then.
I think that is the poison fight. I think that's the one where she basically kills Alphonse before he even gets there.
Talking about Alcor,
anymore. Ooh, there's a Winter Ramada in there. I am just immediately happy to see that unit.
That's awesome.
It's true.
And then Alcor has almost all of our gun picks, so that's interesting. Well, 3 out of 11, I think. So that's also interesting. And then Raph. That Raph is going to win fights by herself, essentially. If you can position her properly away from the rest of your team, the fact that she takes like 4 or 5 hits before going down, especially because the attackers that are going to be hitting Raph are not going to elemental chain with each other as much as they would in a normal build. So the tanks kind of gain extra HP just because of the rule set. I think that's a very strong pick to have.
Yeah. There's a really great, like you said, a maze team that could be put together, Mashery, Raph, and Mish. It could be really interesting with a frog out of there once in a while.
And then we see the Fist team again. We see both Perrine and the Raldor, and you have the Mary Lou.
Oh, yeah. Or Perrine Snow, which is both water, water, ice, and Fist. So you can go both ways.
Yeah, that's also deadly.
That's a nice combo.
I feel like that's a very well-designed concept overall. And as you pointed, Mish earlier, to me, was my main counterpart to Learte. I wasn't sure which one to pick because the instant cast CT down and then the Toad are two tools that your opponent has to be prepared for. So even though it's just a 30 cost in your roster, you're forcing Toad res runes on everybody and whatnot. So it's still a handicap that the enemy has to consider.
Yeah, I think Mish is legit at 30 for all the reasons you said. And don't underestimate him just popping out a flare or if he catches one reflex just buying one extra turn because he does have a Ranger sub.
Fair. Yeah.
Circling back to the beginning, I'm just excited to see that Winter Ramada. I don't think I've ever seen her in a single match, so this will be fun to see.
I want to see her win a fight from Drainforce. If I get that, the tournament has been more than worth it.
All right, so the third team.
Oh, this team sucks. Jeez, well, I can tell us about it, or do you want us to look at it first?
Yeah, go ahead.
I'm one of the 3 Barts players. One of the main things I wanted to go for with this team was picking a bunch of units that pretty much only had like, at least from my account, like a week in the spotlight. So there's a lot of units like Orlando I pulled, I think, on like a second rerun. So at that time, it was just wasn't a whole lot of time to use them. And it's kind of the same with a lot of the other units in my roster, where it's just like they had a little bit of time to shine. But so a lot of my roster that I went with, I did go for a lot of that VC support. So you see a lot of the sword.
Yeah.
Red Mage there.
And Sword Warrior as well.
Yep, that's the team I'm super excited to bust out. I already 140 my Gilgamesh. I'm ready to rock with it. And also, I wanted to go with both Gilgamesh and Miranda. They both have the Time Mage sub, so I'm excited for those shenanigans too.
Yeah, that's where I was going with Miranda and Gilgamesh. You can definitely set up even triple quicken teams. Like, you're fighting an enemy that you think your Jaden might be stronger against. Well, I guess you'd be overcost with that, but you would have some ways of making sure a critical unit goes multiple times and then shutting down an enemy with that.
Yeah, I like this squad a lot, dude. You've got a lot of really nice job synergies and stuff like that. Obviously, talking about I think you're kind of leading towards Bart's Gilgamesh, Zazan all being part of the Sword Warrior group, but Bart's Mariel Naya seems pretty scary on paper, especially considering all 3 are on the Hio VC, which means they all get 18% agility, which is massive for Naya. And she can obviously run a sub, you know, agility VC in the second slot there. Even the red mage, obviously all meshing well together with the murmur. And even if you wanted to, somebody like Naya does fit on, for example, like this, it's not Sephiroth, the Dwayne VC with the AoE resist and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. The both of them are on there. So I definitely like a lot of your job synergies here. It was very, very well done. So
yeah, there's a lot of flexibility.
Yeah. Also, just Miranda generally is a pick. You have long range, re-raise removal, plus the time magic, plus the courage and healing back if you want to go there. So I feel like for her cost, she's one of the best units in the entire roster. Yeah. And just having her in there, especially with like Bart's follow-up attack on a large AoE long range Water God Dispeller, could be very interesting.
I'm wondering about the Bart's Gilgamesh duo.
Me too.
Well, the thing is, you're covering 190 of your cost, so you have to be with Zazan as your last unit. So it's an interesting question how well they're going to work with three different elements.
Correction, you get to be with Zazan as your
there
last.
There you go.
There, Zazan is very strong.
Zazan has the Maneater buff he can apply to Bart for his follow-ups also, which is a cool little synergy there too. So.
Oh man.
Oh shoot, that's true. That. It affects it. Yep. Yeah, okay. I'm now very scared.
PC is switching divisions, right? He said he's going to the other one now.
The next player is Greatest Ness. What we have here? It's about the same.
Lots of Sword Warrior.
I can tell. So he did a couple of things similarly to something he did in the WDL. So he really liked having Hio, King Munt, and Severo as his... that was like his team that he played probably the most in the WDL, because again, they all work on that Hio VC, which is just really good. It's 20 magic resist, 18% agility. It's really, really strong. He didn't do Severo this time, but he did do Zazan, and it still works on that same card really well together. And if he decides that maybe he just needs some extra DPS or a different element, he's got Cloud to sub in instead of, you know, one of those two units. So I like that a lot. That's pretty cool. Just taking a look at some Dark Odin synergy with like Dark Odin and somewhat Sword Mage synergy with Regan, Miranda, Zazan or something like that, I think could be pretty strong. I think he's got some pretty good options. I like him. And even Sakura works on... the Hio VC, so I know that he likes that card a lot because I played against him in the WDL, and that was like both of our most used card. Okay. So I can tell he likes that a lot because most of his team is on that card.
Yeah, that's some good insight to have. I guess the other thing I would point out is Dario and Mariel, you have two different tanks that can have movement of four, potentially a switch and jump as well, with Dario having Shikuchi. So you're able to build a mobile tank that can go pretty much anywhere you need it on the map. And that might just mess up the enemy AI early. Like if you're in a short map, you build up a fairly fast Dario to move in and prevent the enemy team from buffing while he himself survives because he's just insanely tanky for an MR unit. I think there's some stuff to be done with those lower cost tanks here.
I think that EO King Mount is really not to be underestimated. That's a really fearful team. It's really great.
Yeah, I'd be terrified to go up against it. And like I said, he also has that Gilgamesh Miranda time mage, you know, option that I was talking about with my team as well. So yeah, he's definitely got a lot of options on his squad.
He didn't bring Bradley this time.
I'm just happy we don't see many Bradleys so far, because that guy just goes through teams very, very easily.
I think a lot of people are getting away from those units because they just don't feel like playing them, I think.
Yeah, they've seen them so much.
Yeah, I think people are kind of sick of them. That's kind of my guess.
There's three.
Three. Oh, yeah. Three. Yeah, people just didn't go for the meta picks. That's great.
Yeah, I love that. That's awesome.
All right, next one, Iceheart. She went back to Elia. There's no Jaden. Oh, Jaden's not here. Huh, interesting.
I think it's like, that's her
most favorite unit.
Yeah.
Well, that and Starlight Elna. So, but Starlight Elna's there. So.
Yeah.
I'm just noting that we have our only dagger unit of the entire roster is here with Rafale. So that's a cool pick.
Yeah. Very neat.
Huh. That's a good point.
Cadia as well, pretty unit I haven't seen very often, so that's very interesting. I feel like that's probably the roster that is going to be the hardest for me to build against, just because I won't be sure what's coming out in terms of teams on the other side. So that's a really interesting concept. Like, they could go with an evasion heavy team and make that work very well, but they could also be building a team that's just gunning you down with Alaya and Miranda being hasting and going with a lot of damage that way. So there's many different kind of offensive teams you can build.
Two magic tanks, both Mirandas.
Yeah. Yeah, both Mirandas. I was like, I look at this roster, and it was a very Ice Heart roster.
Yeah, yeah.
I see Alaya, I see the Dark Fina and the Starlight Elena, and I'm like, yep.
Yeah, that's really a selection that's representing Ice Art, the unit that she likes. If the unit looks cool to her, pretty, she's going to select them. Shout out to
I'm
you.
I'm always of the opinion.
It's not a bad way to build.
Heck yeah, that's the best way.
That's also a great roster.
Like units, I think if you like the units, then you're going to know them in and out a lot better. And I think that's a good way to win more matches, because you'd be a lot more invested in those characters too.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, it could be luck, could be who was playing, it could be whatever. I started winning a lot more in the WDL when I just decided I want to play the team that I really wanted to play. Maybe that was a coincidence, but I think it was probably also just my best one. But I think there's something to be said about, like, losing doesn't feel nearly as bad if you're playing units that you want to play.
That is so true.
And I also see that the Red Mage combo again. I see, well, this time it's Murmur, mm-hmm. Miranda, and Starlight Elena. So definitely. I know. The Miranda Murmur combo is strong.
We'll see the new Elena VC in action.
Heck yeah.
Oh boy, yeah.
Did she pull for him?
I have no idea, but if she did, that's terrifying. Just to get the evasion and everything. So.
She'll tell us after the video.
I don't believe Elena got guaranteed hit immunity, so for me, it's just, it's not an issue. In my mind, if evasion now without guaranteed hit immunity just is not a factor.
Yeah, that's fair.
I wonder how difficult it was to put up this selection for Isbar, because there was only two fire units that he could bring.
yeah, that's gotta be difficult for a fire specialist. I don't see Lilith here, so he went with Elday, which I know Isbar's Elday is max reincarnated, so that is a good piece of information to have. And then if you look at the cost, they could do Elday Yerma. If you haven't experienced Yerma's damage with her EX job, she one-shots. She gets one-shot in exchange, but she is a massive damage dealer. And they have the Tetra synergy, so they and just these two units together are only covering 130 of your cost, so you still have 90 to work with. So I think that's a potential fun combination, but also he's one of our three Bradley users, so that's also something to consider. Like, they could just go with an Earth superpower.
I have a question for Chise. Is Yerma strong?
just a bit. No, I get to be on the receiving end of Yerma, and it was not fun.
Dude, don't worry, man. I was on the receiving end of that too.
She is very, very fun to play.
Oh my goodness. Quick shout out to Elda Leonis with his new limit break upgrade. He looks pretty legit as a tank, and if he's fully reincarnated, I like what they did, because you could pair him with like a heal support of Valade or something like that, along with any one of those four top tier units. So that's pretty nice. Also, Spear and Staff Devout. So Elda and Valade are both on the Edward Elric card.
Yeah, the one you were talking about earlier.
Yeah, and Glacella Flagbearers, obviously, on that too. So Glacella, Elda, and Valade are all covered on that card.
So, fair. Yeah, there's also Spear synergy with these two.
Mm-hmm. That doesn't sound fun. Don't want to be on the receiving end of that one either.
Yeah, and also, like, we only mentioned physical attackers so far, but there would also be a way, either using Kefka or Summer Helena, we could see a very magic damage heavy team go as well. And that's something that you kind of have to prepare for both. A lot of players have picked either physical or magic tanks, but not everybody has a tank that covers both. So that might just throw a curveball in team building.
And are you going to be prepared for a 67% chance confusion limit break on your party? Probably not.
Exactly.
That's so scary.
So I can imagine that just one thing winning a fight.
Yeah, I was surprised about this because both glove units are 100 cost. So there's no ROI, by example, to make it 190.
Yeah.
I think no one's noticed or mentioned yet is the Golbez pick. Another unit that I just never...
Oh, hell yeah, true!
Is that guy in War of the Visions?
No. Dude, I love it. I'm so happy. I don't even know Isvar, but one of my new favorites. I was so close to picking Golbez and I didn't do it. Now I'm wishing I did because he's the only one. I should have done it.
I'm absolutely loving that pick. I'm hoping to see that one.
But again, Golbez, I mean, if you didn't want to run Elder or something, Golbez, Staff Devout, is on that same Edward card that Glacella is also on and Valade is on. So you could run, like, double damage dealer Golbez Glacella with a Valade in the back. Valade has hate down, so you don't technically need a tank. You can
and you've
just
got
run...
220 right there, so
right.
That's perfect. So
it could be kind of nice.
Next player, Itoman PR.
That's nice. There's more the merrier for that time magic and magic damage potential as well. So I think these two are pretty interesting. And also having Victora in there, you kind of have to be prepared for somebody that can rush through the map and potentially charm multiple of your units if you're splitting. So these immediately jump to mind on top of the usual powerhouses like Bradley and Glaciella Flagbearer. I guess we could see a triple spear team with like Glaciella, Victora, Surgis, which leaves a little bit up there. That could be interesting if they chain together, but definitely difficult to build in terms of VCs.
I also think King Mont is going to be pretty nasty once he gets his limit break upgrade. That thing is no joke. The fact that you can ignore friendly fire on it when it gets upgraded is massive, because if you just want to basically guarantee that he does his limit break, you pretty much can. Where before, like, depending on positioning, he won't always do it, and I don't know, I could see him being pretty insane.
He'll use it way more often.
Yeah,
for sure. I think the damage also gets upgraded too, right? So doesn't it jump up in priority in terms of...
God.
Yeah, I think it goes up 40 mod, and he also gains a somewhat similar effect to Summer Glassy's like damage reduction thing that she has for her allies. So he's getting a good hookup. And I don't know if people really ever run a weapon on him, but I think he gets the new 10% elemental res when you're high on health sword. Which is kind of if you're really wanting to stack elemental res, which he already has a ton of universal elemental res, you can bump that up even higher.
I just looked up his limit break. As you said, it's pretty insane. And there is an aura that appears for allies as well at the end of it. So it's something. Definitely a threat to keep in mind. Although there are many easy ways to prevent Berserk in general across TMRs. So if you see, say if we saw Itoman use King Mont in every battle before yours, you would be able to just prepare yourself against it. Mm-hmm.
It's just one of those things, though, that, like, knowing that if I was going up against them, that they either have an AoE 67% confusion limit break or a Berserk limit break, and I'm like, I'm not going to be able to guarantee I against probably both unless I'm really hard investing for that.
Yeah, I'm starting to think I should have used Rosa and just have that multi-everything prevention. Or Mashuri, whichever.
Shout out to Phoebe, too. Sand Rooster, especially in the WDL, has put in insane work with Phoebe. She gives herself, like, 250 CT when she quickens somebody now. So,
yeah,
just quickening with Phoebe feels really insane sometimes.
Even Little Lila can go 3 times in a row with Phoebe.
Okay, we don't bring that up. That was week one, and it's still too soon. Okay, we don't.
And looking at the top of his roster, all three of those units—I mean, Mont, King of Lilas too—are basically teams on their own. So you can just pair them up with any of the lower cost and just kind of send them on their way. Just pair them up with that little Leela Phoebe and protect them and haste and quicken them up, and they're good to go.
Yep. Top four is scary. So next player is GB79, also really, I appreciate it, man, for joining at the very, very last minute. Thank you very much.
Yeah, he had a bit less time as well to build his roster, which clearly, from what I've heard of his legends in the match, is not going to show when he actually goes in. But yeah, so it's a put together pretty quickly roster.
In the mountains.
Yeah. Well, I mean, massive shout out to him for this. JB's an awesome dude. Dude does a lot for the community, so it's exciting that he's going to be in the league. He definitely stole some pieces from his WDL team that worked well, and then like added more things to it, basically, from what I can see. So he put in a ton of work with Marial. Kefka was like a monster for him all season. Perrine and Urel is a nice little fist combo that he's put in work with Surgez, which is like a full like cold triangle team. So he's put in some things on this team that he's already had good success with, and then I think just adding a bunch of new pieces. Summer Jaden looks pretty terrifying now with his upgrades.
Like
for a while I think regular Jaden was just better. That was my opinion. I don't know. I don't think that's true anymore. Summer Jaden, it looks pretty insane. And he also has like a diamond where regular Jaden just does not have that. And he has double wind missile, which that's just a lot of missile penetration with Jaden's VC. So I don't know. He's got a lot of good stuff here that I think is pretty exciting. And by exciting, I mean not exciting, because I'm pretty sure. I'm probably in his division, aren't I? Are we going one division first? Great. Perfect.
So when you say exciting and terrifying together, yes. And then as you pointed out, Jaden and Cherise plus Marial is going to be very difficult to break through, especially if Jaden uses the AoE slow, because at that point, your capacity to reach the backline just doesn't exist anymore.
Yep. I was just going to shout out Summer Katone real quick.
Yeah.
She gets some pretty solid upgrades, and this is a unit that I think people like forget about. She is actually pretty strong, especially she's for 70 cost.
Very, very good. And if you're thinking, I know JB likes having options like the Rosh Kumps that just instantly win a fight before the team gets ready, and Katone is a master at that. She has a lot of mobility, even as the summer version, and has that AoE slow limit break that just instantly shuts down the enemy team, which now also hastes her, because why not? I think she's a great pick, which fun story I got from the raid ticket. Randomly, so I was very happy with that.
I've lost to a lot of summer ketones in manual class matches.
Oh, yeah.
Because of that mobility. I don't want to be in your shoes, guys, when this guy is going to bring Kefka, Ketone, and Marielle in the same comp.
Yeah. Oh, he's been putting in work with Kefka, Revelka, and Marielle, and I think summer ketones just better. So, I don't know, man. Like, I don't like that. I don't like it.
I really like it. We'll see.
I also love the fact that he's bringing not only the new Jaden, but also three of the summer units with their new upgrades. So it's to test out all the new toys that just came out here recently.
Yeah.
He has some threatening tier threes too. McCloud and Dia are both like really threatening for low cost units. Like they can put in some damage for sure.
Urel also being really great this season in WDL. She can put up a fight.
I won't spoil. I'm sure this will come out after, but you guys don't know. So I won't spoil whether I won or lost versus JB. But one of the hardest things that I had for my team personally to try and prep for on his team was Urel. Because I had like three different units who were very courage focused. And Urel being able to give her party members the ability to get rid of courage was so difficult to try and figure out a solution for. And I think Urel is, it's just such a nice thing to have on your team, so that somebody else like facing you can't just, no problem, run courage and not worry about it. That's, yeah.
Next is a Jesus.
Oh, I spotted Gargass and I'm very happy.
Oh.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
It is our Sephiroth player. He's the one.
The Sephiroth player and the Bard's player, the second of the three.
All right, so a couple of quick things to shout out. Gargus is very legitimate, just as an AD coster, being able to put down a massive AoE resist debuff from insane range. Like, his range is just absolutely ridiculous. Warrior of Light is an absolutely phenomenal tank, and I'm just doing a quick scan through his team. Again, he has a lot of Sword Warrior and Staff Black Mage synergy, which is that heal card, and then he has a bunch of Sword Red Mage who all fit together very nicely. So he has Ferris, Orlando, and Murmur, who are, I'm sure, will be a team together. So
yeah, I'm also seeing if, depending if he has an enemy that has ice power, but Edward plus Raldor, very strong combination.
Mm-hmm. With Mereluk. And one thing I'll say is Mereluk is a monster. We had costs set up in the WDLs, like custom costs, and Numero modified some of those, and I think all the changes that he made, I think, were good changes. I think we probably could have put Mereluk to 50, and it probably would have been just fine. Her and Etra are both 40. Personally, I think Mereluk is just straight better than her, like, in every regard. That team is going to slap. That team is going to be really good.
One thing that I really wanted to do for this tournament was to put Edward at 100 cost, because I think that right now, Alphonse and Edward, it's only too much. That's a kind of unbreakable team with great support from the VCs. And
yeah, and Edward at 100 just doesn't feel that out of place to me. He's an amazing unit, so
not at all.
I think that fits.
I completely agree.
I guess the last thing I'll point out here, for me at least, is Sephiroth, Whisper, Murmur team also sounds disgusting. Yeah, it's not one I'm looking forward to facing either. So definitely putting together some really strong teams I'm seeing here.